The chestnut game was truly outstanding game. The chestnut game, the neighbor Danakulens created for the chestnut a special metal rod that you would just push against let me find one of those. See, the one for demonstration purpose is to demonstrate you basically right in the center of it. He would squeeze that thing and it would split chestnut, like, I don't know, maybe even in three or four pieces, I don't know. And just against the floor, and that's it, just against the bottom, and that's it. And it would open. And well, we did go to Bela Krajina with him, at the top of Gorjanci, and a little bit on the other side, and they caught him time and again. They always caught him taking too much. The limit is 2 kilos. That's the limit. So you have this thing here. So we would do is he would take like a metal rod and he would go like this, and it would split into three pieces. Then he would grab this, the interior, the inside, and so on. Yeah, and this is quite important stuff. I'm gonna still use this one to complete this report. This is the location where the village people did a lot of crime against me. The whole village used to come here to pick up the chestnut, and my mother delivered me here one time to pick up the chestnut, and it was a neighbor. I just ate like crazy at home. I had a full stomach, and we came here to pick up the chestnut, and the thing was, it was the whole forest of the people. One of the people was my neighbor, German. Now, already gone, he passed away. And I had a good time. I wanted to play with him a little bit because he was a neighbor, it was an older uncle, and I want to have a good time with him. And I found him that he worked so diligently picking up the chestnut, you know, everywhere, picking up this stuff, and you know. And he had many bags, you know. He had, I don't know how many bags already of this chestnut. And he just was picking up, and then he hurried to his bag. He was placing one bag after another. So I decided I'm gonna start taking the bags away from him. And it was gone, one bag gone. And I watched him, what he's doing, not realizing that the village people were watching me, what I was doing. That's what mother brought me here for. Then I saw him come to the bag, and he was looking, and he was like, "Oh fuck, one bag is missing." Okay, so first I was where the mother was, and I was watching him from far away how he's gonna react. Then I realized that he is just like he would be having some kind of, he acted like he had some kind of, that it was just happening to him, basically, that he had so many bags, right? And so I saw him doing this stuff, and when I saw him that it was just in a such a state of mind, I started to feel sorry for him. I didn't like the idea that he was picking up so diligently the stuff and collecting it and taking it back to his bags. I really didn't like the idea because it reminded me of me, what they were doing to me. So what he was doing is he was imitating me, the stuff that was done to me. And that's something I didn't realize. But what I wanted to see is, I decided I want to see if he's going to find another one. So what I did was, I went and I took the second bag, the same shit repeated, the third bag, the same shit repeated. It was like, he doesn't know what the fuck he's doing. Then I no longer wanted to be next to my mom. And I walked to him and I started to be around him. And I was started to give him a funny looks and asking him questions to see if he's gonna say, give me my chestnut back or whatever. So I decided I'm gonna help him out with it. He apparently still did not realize this. And then what I did was I went to my mom and I said to my mom, to whom I brought those, I said, listen, mom, these are from the neighbor, these bags. We have to give him back this stuff. Well, the thing about it was that it was his son, who was teenagerman, who said that I was driving his father insane, that he saw me. So the village people had everything video recorded, and I became guilty of what was known as deliberately driving Father Yerman insane. This is how it all started with a chestnut here in this place. The village people did a lot of crime already against me by then. This is just one of the excerpts that I think it's worthy of my video recording it. Rotten people, that it couldn't be more rotten. Then what they would do is they would continue to deliver me here over the course of the years with the parents drugged up under MK Ultra. And it would be all kinds of stuff, including beatings that would take place, accusing me that I was trying to drive him insane and stuff like this. Why I was doing completely insane stuff with the village people, literally farmers, Senichar, and so on, inside of our house, eating chestnut at our table with the parents, with me, fantasizing, laughing and stuff like this. But it was a police officer neighbor. His name is Metod Yerman, a cousin of the son from this from the father from who passed away, man who passed away, who was literally selected as an individual who started to enforce physical violence on me inside of this forest, beginning here in the forest. What this individual would do, he was always used to intimidate inside of the forest, and when I would not comply with it, what he would do is, they said they're gonna summon this guy so that he will come and cause me harm. What's interesting is, which I just drew away a little bit further, is from Senichar. Probably where the light is right there. That would be probably from Senichar, who claimed me that he's gonna fuck me if I'm gonna throw to him this spiny stuff. That they're gonna go and they're gonna do analysis and I don't know what. People also claim they're gonna video record the stuff and I'm gonna be picking up the chestnut here. Well, this is the first year we have the asphalt. All this shit was part of MK Ultra. literally all this stuff is basically that went on. So yeah, I would know a little bit about all this stuff. And it was more stuff that I don't want to talk about, but doesn't really matter. Yeah, what can I say? At night time, the village people, the such righteous people, they would go and they would steal the chestnut, what they refer to as stealing in their forests. Chestnut not allowed, mushroom not allowed, I don't know what they fantasize. They would come here at night and they would started to pick up the chestnut here all over this hill. and so on and so on and so forth. A little bit about MK Ultra, about what went on, what the fuck went on. Yeah. No. I would know something about this already, what I stated. If I would submit this to police, this already would be enough to spark investigation. But there is just so much other stuff, including me being in Ljubljana and on a police station with, I don't know what kind of police station that was, but that was like a central police station in Ljubljana where they had drones, literally using them with a thermal vision, nights going scanning the forests, and literally would be picking on the people that would go after chestnut at night, night chestnut pickers. And then what they would do is they would just, with a thermal vision, they would demonstrate me how they managed to zoom at the guy that was picking up chestnut, and it was a police officer. They were waiting for him to come out of the forest. Zoom, they would give him a ticket, whatever. Chestnut, just like this here that you see, that reminded of the road, was picked up all over the Europe. Some with Ukrainians that came. Other chestnut we were picking up in Serbia. I remember we were picking up this chestnut in the Serbs, with the Serbs. What the Serbs said to me, I will not forget this. That was a good one. I don't know, but it quite looked like this here. Somewhat, it reminded of this stuff here, and that was funny stuff. They said to me, I don't know, they made the whole thing feel like I am here, but at the same time in Serbia. Then it was also other locations, for some of which they claimed that because of me they went on and they seeded a chestnut so that I could go and report in the future on how it was because of me that on that location they seeded the chestnut and all kinds of shit like this. This was all over Slovenia, in the Serbia, it was in Ukraine, it was all over the Europe, probably in Russia too, everywhere it was displayed with the chestnut. In Poland, of course. In Poland, there is an expression, there is a word, they say schudneli, and it was with Andrzej Duda and with the Morawiecki, they were picking up chestnut, and they were sticking the chestnut behind the belly and stuff, and they were laughing about how the lady met the guy who had a big stomach, and the next day she saw him completely with flat stomach and could not understand how he lost the weight so fast and so on. That kind of stuff, all kinds of stupidities, all kinds of shit. So a little bit about MK Ultra chestnut picking.